Then we go to Morgenthau. Poor Morgenthau. You know, everyone thinks Morgenthau is this great ambassador that did great things for Armenia and so on and so forth. Well, wouldn't you be surprised to find out that Morgenthau was a spy and he was sent there on a secret mission by Washington, D.C.? Would you be surprised? Well, don't be surprised, because that's exactly what he was, and it's all documented in the book. Morgenthau wasn't there to help the Armenians. Morgenthau was there to make a deal with the Turks to actually, at some point, in fact, Jacob H. Schiff tried to make a deal twice, once to buy land in Mesopotamia in 1909, it's in the book also, and then later on they tried to buy Palestine for Israel. So we go in pretty deep with Morgenthau because there's a lot of materials out there. And those materials, by the way, I found in newspapers. So you have to understand something. All these big bankers, they owned newspapers to censor what was being printed. But they made a mistake because they figured, let's own the major. They went cheap, basically. They should have owned all of them if they were smart, but they weren't. They would buy about 50% of the major newspapers so things wouldn't get out. But they didn't realize that one day, all those little newspapers that they didn't buy were eventually going to be archived and you can get them online. And today, you can actually go to newspapers.com, get a 7-day free trial to start with, and you will drown in these articles that you never knew existed. And I've got a bunch of them in this book right now. And it spells out who Morgenthau was. He himself, with his own mouth, said, "I was on a secret mission from Washington." Those are his own words. He was quoted here. And in fact, when Morgenthau had come to the United States to beg for money for the Near East Foundation for the Armenians, or relief for the Armenians, maybe even before Near East began, the same day he would have a meeting with businessmen to have them invest in Turkey. So here he is, he's saying, you know, help the Armenians, and then he goes to a different event and says, invest in Turkey, they will remember you. One day they're going to stand on their feet, start investing. So this is who really Morgenthau was. So when the Armenians, every time the Armenians celebrate Morgenthau, I just kind of cringe and go, they just don't know. Well, now they're going to know. So this is who Morgenthau is. Read chapter 13. Oh, that's interesting. I didn't even plan that. Chapter 13, unlucky 13, unlucky Morgenthau. He was not lucky for us. Okay.